Welcome to a lesson on tangent lines to a circle. The goal of this video is to state and prove the tangent to a circle theorem. The tangent to a circle theorem states a line is tangent to a circle if and only if the line is perpendicular to the radius drawn to the point of tangency. So in our diagram here, our tangent line would be line BC, and our radius would be segment AB. Notice how B is the point of tangency, and this theorem states that these would be perpendicular and therefore form a 90 degree angle. Now notice how this is a biconditional or if and only if statement. Therefore, it's also true that if the radius is perpendicular to a line that intersects the circle in one point, it must be a tangent line. So in this video, we're going to prove it in one direction. We're going to prove if a line is tangent to a circle, then the line is perpendicular to the radius at the point of tangency. And we're going to prove this using an indirect proof, which means we're going to assume that they are not perpendicular and then try to contradict the assumption. So again, here's our diagram where line BC is tangent to the circle at point B and segment AB is the radius of the circle. So again, we're going to use an indirect proof. So we'll start by assuming that segment AB is not perpendicular to line BC. So if these aren't perpendicular, then there must exist some other point, let's call it point D, let's go ahead and put it here, such that segment AD or radius AD would be perpendicular to line BC. So again, if they're not perpendicular, then there exists the point D. Such that segment AD would be perpendicular to line BC. Now, since the perpendicular segment is the shortest distance between a point and a line, the length of AD would have to be less than the length of AB. Again, this would have to be true if we're assuming that segment AD is perpendicular to the tangent line BC. But now, since line BC intersects circle A in one point B, point D must lie on circle A, so the length of AD is greater than the length of AB. And here's our contradiction that we're looking for. But the length of AD being greater than the length of AB contradicts what we said above, that AD is less than AB. So our assumption must be false. Remember, our assumption was that segment AB is not perpendicular to line BC. Now that we've contradicted our assumption, we have our proof. Therefore, segment AB must be perpendicular to line BC, where segment AD is the radius of the circle. I hope you found this proof helpful.